Hey guys, welcome back to the Sailing with Gusto program. I have a real passion to try to get people to stand together and fight against evil in our country and around the world. My voice might be small, but it's the one I got. Anyway, I'm working on another video now, but it's going to take a while, so I just threw this together. The end of boating season's coming up, and I have some little cuts like cooking lobster and cleaning mackerel and stuff like that, so I threw together this short video. Hope you like it, and I hope I can get this other video done that I'm working on done in a reasonable time. Take care. Hey guys, it's a foggy day here at the Maine coast, and I bought a new mainsail. Had it made in Thailand, Southeast Asia sails, and it's my fault, but I had them put the wrong slugs on it so it don't fit, so I had to take them all off. So what I'm going to be doing is, these are the slugs that came with it. I got to take these off, sew new ones on, then sew that one. So this should take over 3 hours. So I'll let you know the progress. All right, so what we're doing here, we're changing the slugs out. These are the old slugs. These are the ones that we got to put in, the flat slides. The only ones that'll fit in the mast. So basically, we take it off. We got this little tool right here. Just get underneath the threads. Cuts them off pretty efficiently. Okay. Like that. Got the pliers. What you do after you sew this, you take the hot iron and you melt the fibers. It's almost out of there. Little bugger. There. Take that out. Alright, so anyway, I'm not gonna bore you too much with this, but take the slide, put it in here, just like that. I got my needle. I got a certain way I've been doing this. It looks about the same way it was done before. We'll leave a little tail out there to burn. All right, we have some butane. A little torch comes in handy. Yeah, so what we gotta do, there's a finished one, and I just take the two tails and I burn them down and put some pressure on them, and that's all set. And then we gotta sew these to the sail. All right, we made some progress on the sail. Now I'm putting these slides on. I gotta have a way I can do consistently. So I fold them up. Keep in mind, I'm not a professional sailmaker, but I think I can make this work. Okay. So. I still want the tails to come out in the same place. I want the tails to come out in the same place, so when I melt them together, they're going to be just in the same spot. And surprisingly, the needle goes through here pretty easy until I put a lot of stitches in it. All right. Again, if you're a professional sailmaker, you see I'm doing something wrong, let me know. If this thing stays on, I'll know I did something right. Yeah, that's not bad. All right, we got a treat. Gonna have lobsters. I don't have lobsters all the time. I wish I did, and I like to buy them right from the boat. This guy came around. Art got some lobsters. Yummy. So we're gonna cook lobsters. The boat is a little disarray. I got some coffee going there. a nice cold coffee. I'm gonna boil up some water, cook some lobsters. Been doing video today. And kind of messy. Just, we'll clean up later. Yeah, so we're gonna cook up some lobsters. All right, so here we go. Turn on the stove. They don't have any butter, so I'll have to eat these things. Put that on high. I'm just gonna eat them with salt, maybe a little garlic powder on them. But you don't need much water. I'm gonna put like maybe a half inch, little, maybe under a half inch. Okay. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get the water going. Get it boiling nice. Put these guys in there. Oh, yummy. You're gonna be good. I got them from Art. I got them from a guy, from a lobster. I got them from a lobsterman. His name is Art. He's 72 years old. Just got a little boat. It's all dirty and nasty and everything. Just nice guy. Salt of the earth kind of guy. I hope to see him again. I hope to get more lobsters. Yeah, this is only like the second time that we had lobsters since I had the boat on here. No, third time. But yeah, it's nice. It's a treat. Thank God for it. All right. All right, here we go. And we want to get this boiling really good, which it is. In you go. In you go. In you go. Okay. All right. So they're done. Yummy. We're going to make some lobster rolls tonight. Oh, I can't wait. We're going to make the ultimate lobster roll. Gotta stay tuned for that. So I was on the boat catching mackerel. I was slaying them. Of course, I didn't have the camera. But I'm going to clean them up, count them. I remember when my dad used to catch mackerel. He used to fill the boat full of them. Just loved it. So it looks like we've got some weather coming. So whatever I got to do quickly, unless I want to be soaked. Andrew? No. Oh. All right. We're going to... cleaning these is not my favorite part of this, but it's what's got to be done.
It's Atlantic mackerel, correct?
Yeah, I believe so.
Okay. Yeah, those are the little mackerel.
Yep, those are the little ones.
I think that's called an Atlantic mackerel. It's not a Spanish mackerel.
You know, mackerels get huge because of the Philippines.
King mackerel, they go crazy for in Carolinas.
Oh, really?
And I went beach casting at Hatteras. For Spanish mackerel, and they were in the water, but I didn't catch one because I didn't know what I was doing. Oh. I think that was largely, I've done a lot of blue fishing and striper and things of that nature.
Haven't caught a bluefish in a while.
But those Spanish mackerel are similar to a bluefish in the way they hit a lure. They swim very fast, yep. Maybe not quite as like strong or aggressive maybe, but yeah, you got that right.
Yeah, I get myself in this mark once. I think I cut myself too bad. I don't like to cut myself at all.
Who does, right?
Yep. Yeah, what a good-looking little fish.
I brought beef with me because I want to eat beef, but my wife's from the Philippines. She loves mackerel. My son does too. I do too. I'm just not going to eat them tonight because I plan on my beef. But yep. I eat the skin and everything. I roll them in some seasoned flour or whatever. And normally I leave the tails on too because I eat the tails, but I got so many of them.
A good little handful. That's awesome.
But I just keep on. I should have stopped. I was like my dad, you know. No. As long as they're biting,
keep going.
It don't matter if the boat is going down. If they're still biting, the law is you keep
fishing.
Yep.
It's awesome.
Yeah, come on, Dad.
Yeah. Have a nice weekend. If I don't see you,
all right, thank you. Too. Hopefully, we see you before the end of the season.
Oh yeah.
Next week don't look good either. Looks like a lot of rain.
Didn't like that.
Yeah, we're headed out to Hurricane Island again. Just me and my son. gonna check it out. Beautiful out here today.
Yeah, I'm also excited to go to Hurricane Island. We're only going there for a day. I'm hoping that we'll do some really great hiking there and maybe some exploring.
See that buoy? You like electronics? I do. One of the favorite pieces of electronics on this boat is the autopilot right here. This will keep you going on course. It has the compass, all different kinds of settings for nighttime and all that. I can go plus or minus 10 degrees, plus or minus 1 degree. And this is it in action right now. That's a wheel pilot. This thing right here has the motor right here, has a belt. The best drive, that's the drive system. The best one is the hydraulic drive, where it drives it down there, the same brain, but that's what we got. It's within budget. And when it comes to boats too, you always want to be in budget. If I had a bigger budget, I'd have a bigger boat. But yeah, this is what we got, and I thank God for it. Yeah, my new mainsail from Southeast Asia Sails. Okay, very good to deal with, very excellent price.
All right, here we are. Pretty good. We're getting closer to Hurricane Island. We got a good breeze out here, it's not that bad. Got the full main, and we have the storm sail up. Check it out. Moving along at about 5 knots. Pretty nice out here sailing now, you gotta love it. Good exercise too. Headed to Hurricane Island. We got the main, the new main, and the new storm sail up. Looking good. Now, if you can look off there, you got Little Hurricane and Hurricane off in the island, off in the distance there. You got my son there just chilling out, kicking back with the shades on. Oh, he loves it. He loves being a kid. All right. We're almost there. We're doing some motoring. The wind's died down. It's beautiful out here. Yep. Then hopefully there's a mooring for us. We can pick up a mooring, go explore the island, use the drone, spend the night. My son looks still tired. Yeah, he's loving it. We're back. You know what? I'm glad to be back. Hurricane Island, we did it. This is nice, check it out. We got the kid. Yeah. I'd be lying if I said we weren't a little bit hungry. Yeah, so we're going to get something to eat, and then son, turn off the autopilot, buddy. And then we're going to explore the island a little bit. And then come back and have some grilling and sundowners, and should be good. All right, here we are. We're going to have something to eat before we disembark. We got some African rice going on. Yummy. African rice from Rahima. Yummy. Yeah, so here's the boat. We got provisions.
Yesterday we were at church, the Harvest Church, which is
got my son on his computer there.
And I was standing next to
got some Glenn Beck going. So yeah, we're gonna eat, then we're gonna do a little exploring.
Everything in this
cool. All right, coming into Hurricane. We had some deep. Now we're gonna check it out. Use the drone. My son's gonna do the docking operation.
you got this? This is difficulty. Do you have this?
Yes.
Here we go, boys.
I'm lying. No, I'm not.
Good job, bud. Bud. They quarried out granite. Real nice. This is a great spot. Good morning. Yeah, we're supposed to have rain later in the day. And tomorrow rain. So we're going to go back to the moor and go home. I'm gonna come back out, and if I have crew or if I can do some editing out there, I'm gonna do that. Look at the fog. 10 degrees on the minus, buddy.